This video covers how you can use cost per click or CPC bidding to bid on your Google Hotel ads. Let's start with some reasons why you might choose to use cost per click bidding. CPC bidding lets you specify the most you're willing to pay for a click on a hotel ad. Then you only pay when somebody actually clicks on your hotel ad, often less than your max CPC bid. If you plan to actively manage your hotel ads campaign, using CPC will give you granular controls to optimize your performance based on your marketing and distribution strategy. Using CPC bids with hotel ads is pretty straightforward. You set a base bid. This base gets multiplied by any bid multipliers you set. And the result is your total CPC bid. Let's walk through these two components in more detail. When you're setting a CPC base bid, you have two options. First, you can bid a percentage of the room rate. Since hotel rates fluctuate based on factors like weekday versus weekend and the type of room, using percentage of room rate aligns your investment with the potential revenue from that booking. As an example, let's say you bid 1% on a property with a $150 per night rate, and that property is eligible to show to a searcher looking for two nights. Since all bids get multiplied by the number of nights in the query, you would end up having a total bid of $3. Your second CPC option is bidding a fixed cost per click per night. This bid is the maximum cost you're willing to pay for a click on a property. And taking the example from before, let's say you bid $2 for that same property. Your $2 bid gets multiplied by two nights for a total bid of $4. In most cases, when you're using CPC, we recommend using percentage of room rate bidding because it tailors your willingness to pay to the revenue of the room being booked. In other words, more expensive rooms automatically get higher bids. As mentioned before, your base bids can get multiplied by any bid multipliers you choose to set. These multipliers allow you to custom tailor your bids to any conversion rate trends you see around factors like the user's device, country, or length of stay. In total, you have six bid multiplier options. Hopefully the names on most of these let you know what they do, but as a quick review, you have the device type multiplier, which lets you increase or decrease bids for users on mobile devices, user country, where you can adjust bids according to any conversion rate trends you see around user location, length of stay, which is typically used to decrease bids for longer stays since they typically have lower conversion rates, Google site, which lets you adjust bids according to where your users are engaging with your hotel ads, check-in day, which helps you adjust bids by day of the week, for example, bidding more for Friday check-ins as they tend to have multiple night stays, and last but not least, advanced booking window, which can be used to increase bids for searchers looking for accommodations sooner, as they're more likely to need to book sooner. Let's look at how all these multipliers work together to determine your total bid. Let's say someone searches for a $150 room for two nights on Google Maps from their mobile device. Taking our 1% of room rate bid base from earlier and adding two bid multipliers, here's what happens. First, the base bid calculation from earlier in this video occurs. So 1% bid times $150 rate times two nights equals a $3 base. Next, we multiply the two multipliers, a 10% increase for maps and a 5% decrease for mobile phone users. And the final result is a $3.14 total bid. Note how bid multipliers are additive and independent of one another. This means you need to ensure you're considering your overall strategy and you're aware of the cumulative effect of your multipliers.